which is that the Brazilian Senate approved a government-sponsored series of labor reforms. So could you tell us about those reforms and how the approval by the Senate, as reports are suggesting, might boost the Temer government? Temer himself, of course, facing corruption charges, as you mentioned, and in fact, Brazil's first sitting head of state to be formally charged with a crime.
Yeah, I'm really glad that you asked that, because there's no way to discuss the situation in Brazil without understanding the agenda of international finance and domestic oligarchs, in particular their desperation to impose extremely harsh austerity measures on an already suffering poor population. Michel Temer, shortly after he was installed as president, came to New York and spoke to a gathering of hedge funds and foreign policy elites in New York and said that the real reason Dilma was impeached was not because of these budgetary tricks she was accused of using, but it was because she was unwilling to impose the level of austerity that international capital and the business interest in Brazil wanted. That's why they put Temer into office, to quote unquote reform pensions and labor laws, to make people work longer, to extend their retirement rate, to reduce their benefits. This is what the whole thing is about. And it's amazing, because every time it looks like Temer is going to stay, the real increases in strength, as does the Brazilian stock market. Every time it looks like he's in trouble, the real decreases and the Brazilian stock market weakens, because international finance wants Temer to stay, because he's the only one willing to impose these harsh austerity measures, because he's already so unpopular and so old that he's not going to run again and can't run again, so he doesn't care. He's willing to do their dirty work for him. At the same time, yesterday, when Lula got convicted and it looked like, or the court has declared him ineligible to run again in 2018, what happened to the real? It skyrocketed against the dollar. The Brazilian stock market boomed, because international finance wants the right to take over and continue to maintain power in Brazil. So everything is about the underlying attempt to take away the benefits from the nation's poor that PT has legislated for them, to make people work longer hours, to make them have fewer benefits, to transfer wealth from the laborers in this country and the poor in this country back to the oligarchs. That's why Dilma was removed. That's why Michel Temer is in power. That's why they want to make Lula ineligible. And so that is absolutely what lurks at the center of all of this intrigue.
Well, Glenn, please stay with us. We're talking about the former Brazilian president, Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva, convicted on corruption charges and sentenced to 9.5 years in prison. When we come back, we'll speak with the Pulitzer Prize-winning journalist Glenn Greenwald.